Hey everyone, welcome back. And it is New Year's Eve, so right on. Tomorrow will be a new year for everyone. And hopefully it's a better one for everyone. Guys, so I'm going to admit, I made a big critical mistake. Oh guys, very disappointed. And I just noticed it like maybe 30 minutes ago. Alright guys, so here. I'm not sure if you guys can see. It's going to be too hard to see because my camera adjusts the focus and the brightness of everything. But what happened here, guys, is I'm actually starting to remove the cabinets again. I'm removing them. I was almost done level. I actually had all these leveled. I was on my last one over here, putting this one in. And I noticed that I made a critical mistake, guys. Critical mistake. And I thought I measured it right, but I guess I didn't. So what I'm talking about is, so I sanded my cabinets and I painted them, right? It looks good. Don't get me wrong. But the issue was that I was assuming, which I shouldn't have done, I was assuming that 1 gallon of paint was going to be enough to paint all these pieces of cabinets and drawers and everything else. And I was wrong. So what happened was, so I used up the first gallon of paint. But when I used that first gallon of paint, because the paint was so thick, I had to thin it, right? In order to get a really nice flat finish. And don't get me wrong, I do have a really nice flat finish, really nice. And then what happened was I ran out of paint. So then I had to go and buy another gallon of paint, right? And so I'm like, okay, so I told myself, okay, I gotta thin it because I thinned the first one. And when I thinned it, I thought I thinned it to the same ratio of the first gallon, and I did not. And it's apparent because I was walking around the house, and earlier, like maybe 30 minutes ago or so, we had more sunlight in the house, and the sunlight really opened, you know, because I have white walls, so it made everything bright. And I could obviously tell there is a tone difference between the first set of cabinets that I painted with the first gallon and the second set of cabinets that I'm painting with the second gallon. The second gallon that I'm using, the color on the cabinets is way darker than the first gallon that I used, okay? And it has nothing to do with how the store mixed it. They mixed it to exactly what it's supposed to be per, you know, per the gallon. The problem was that I didn't thin it correctly. I did not thin it to the same ratio, and I thought I did. And so it's obvious I did not. And so this is a big critical mistake on my side, guys. It's a big fail. You know, we live and learn. You know, it's just really a downer because I put a lot of time into doing this already. These cabinets, I've been working on this for some time now, guys. I mean, I've been spending late hours, guys, sanding and primering and sanding and primering and getting really nice finishes. But at the end of the day, guys, I made a mistake, right? So I'm going to own up to it. It was my mistake that I didn't thin it identically. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all these cabinets again, and I'm going to sand them all down. Okay. Remove them all. I'm going to sand them all back down, and I'm going to do this because I know I need at least 2 gallons to finish all this now, right? So I'm going to get 2 gallons. I'm going to pour the 2 gallons into each other, right? So that way, those two colors are guaranteed mixed together and one base color. Even though the store is mixing them, let's just mix them all together. And then I'm going to thin that big batch the same, right? So I can thin that batch. That way that whole batch of 2 gallons will be the same consistency throughout all the paint, right? That way when I spray the color, all my cabinets will match. Right. And so that's what I should have done from the beginning. But I was thinking and hoping that a 1 gallon would have been enough. But because I'm putting like 4 coats on each one to really make a nice finish, you know, I'm eating up through quite a bit of paint. And so, you know, it is. And then I think on the first cabinet that I did, because the paint was so thick, I had to thin and thin and thin. And that's what really threw me off, was because the paint was so thick, I had to learn that paint in order to thin it correctly, in order to have it spray correctly and smooth, right? So I used a lot of paint on that first cabinet because I sanded it off. I did that cabinet like 4 times That first one. So a lot of extra work going into this, guys. A lot of extra work. So am I disappointed? Yeah. But here's the thing, guys. Some people may say it's not a big deal. It's you can leave it, and they would leave it. But I'm not. I cannot live with myself seeing two different tones. Even though they're the same color, it's two different tones. One is darker and one is lighter. The one that's lighter it's obvious that I thinned that one more. And the one that's darker, it's obvious that I didn't thin that one as much, right? So the color scheme is not the same. It's still the same, you know, Broadway, but I thinned it too much, or I didn't thin it enough on the second one. So like even these in here, you know, I sprayed these last night. I've been going on these two in here, and you know, I'm actually done with these. I was just waiting for this one over here needed a second coat. Well, I mean, one more coat, but I was pretty much done with these. And these were the last two pieces for all these cabinets. But, it is what it is. And here I am thinking about, you know, getting the LifeProof flooring out and get that project going already in the next day. But obviously I can't do that. I need to readdress these cabinets, get them all squared away. And then from there, get them installed, leveled, and then I can start working on my flooring. So here's the thing, guys. I'm not hiding nothing from nobody. You know, I made a mistake and I'm going to own up to it. And, you know, more of the story here is, guys, take my mistake and maybe don't make it. Don't make that same mistake, right? So just pay attention to what you're doing. Like this, I'll give you guys an example. So the painting of my house here, right? All the walls and everything. We mixed all the paint together. And when we thinned it, we thinned all the paint together. So it was the same consistency. So my walls all match. Ceiling walls, it's the same tone all the way through. Because we mixed it all as a batch. And we thinned it all as a batch. So it all matches. In this case, I was hoping I was going to get away with 1 gallon. And that was obviously not the case. Then when I got that second gallon that I purchased and I thinned it down, I obviously didn't thin it enough. And, you know, that kind of stuff. And I can't even remember how much I thinned the first one now that I'm thinking about it, because this has been an ongoing project now for, what, a week or more now? So, yeah, guys, you know, learn from my mistakes. Definitely learn from my mistakes. And here's the thing, guys, I knew better. I honestly knew better. But I honestly thought I thinned it the same. That's what I was thinking in my head. I'm like, wait a minute, because I have my measuring cups in there. And I'm like, okay, I use this, so I'll do the same thing. And that's what I did. But obviously, I did not. What I think I didn't do was I don't think I compensated for the first cabinet that I was testing on, because I kept thinning the paint down. And I think that's what threw me off in the end. But anyway, guys, you know, it is what it is. So hopefully I can get all these removed, and I'm going to sand them all the way back down to the wood. And then we're going to go ahead and repaint. Now, some of you may say, oh, all you have to do is lightly sand them, and then you can recoat them and go from there. You could, but I'm a little picky. So if I'm going to take them all down and redo it, I'm going to redo them all the right way. And just, you know, put a heavier grit of sandpaper on my sander and just take it down real quick. You know, that's the good thing about having power tools, right? You can make quick work of things. And then when we get ready to paint them, I'll do the same process as I did. Just make sure I thin everything and mix everything in a big batch. So like this one on the bottom right here, guys, the corner caddy, the one that has the two lazy Susans, to the one to the right. The one to the right is darker than the one in the corner. And then the one to the left of that corner one is also darker than that corner one. And then this piece up here is a little bit darker than these two pieces on this side, right? And that's because this was from the second gallon of paint. And here's the thing too, it's black, right? So I'm spraying these at night. I'm working on this at night, and it's hard to tell the tones, right, when you don't have like true daylight. And then like today, I'm actually home in the afternoon and I have daylight, and I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on here? Something is not right. I thought maybe I didn't spray enough on, but I was like, wait a minute, I have over four coats on each cabinet, so that's not the case, right? And I was thinking, oh no, I didn't thin it correctly. So anyway, guys, I hope your guys' projects are doing better than mine right now. But at the end of the day, guys, you know, I take pride in my work, and I am going to absolutely remove all these cabinets, sand them all down, and I'm going to completely make sure I double check and triple check my you know, my thinning process on all my paint, and we're going to spray all the cabinets one time. So I'm going to line up a bunch of these cabinets in that room and just kind of get them all lined up so I can spray them all one crack, hopefully. And then, you know, just keep moving forward, guys. So, you know, hey, we live and learn, guys. We live and learn. So anyway, guys, happy New Year's. And I hope you guys' projects go well. I'll see you guys in the new year. Happy New Year, guys.